Today, the students need to have actual exposure to working, and that is possible only when there is a good linkage with the industry and they get to know what is happening in the industry. Otherwise, converting that knowledge into skill, which makes sure that how the information that you have acquired can be put into a practical application is very important, and that is where institutions like this have made a mark. And it's a good this thing, and also to see that, for example, the jumps of ISBR, where they are trying to capture some of the students who have done well, recognizing them, is a good event. Primarily, what the students of today have to appreciate is India is on the poised for a great leap in the world, and unless you commit yourself and you dedicate yourself with the knowledge that you have acquired and bring it to a specific solution to the problems we face in the society and how to make use of this knowledge, that responsibility, we want the students who are coming out to take that responsibility, because they have had a great privilege of participating or getting this knowledge from such institutions. It should be actually brought into effective use. Today, for example, what was one of the things we keep telling earlier is the earlier generation had the advantage of the slowly changing world. But today the world is changing at such a pace that the process of learning is more important than what you learn itself. That's where we were talking about learning, unlearning, relearning. So this is an essential, so it's a lifelong activity, but the whole process is shrinking fast and you need to act faster and faster. That is the real requirement. Leaders in the organizations are facing the challenge, because finally the leaders have to make sure that it is the entire force that is available to them who deliver. And for that to happen, you need to make sure that you have enough talent pool available. So that is one of the difficulties that they have. But then, from among the available talent pool, how to deliver is the challenge of the leader. If you see, we had Dr. H. Narasimhaya, who was the principal at the National College. He was my, actually you can say, the first person who made a great influence directly. But otherwise, in terms of reading, we had Vivekananda and all his teaching we were reading. But in real life, it was H. Narasimhaya, whose simplicity and then his commitment to bringing his knowledge to the use in the society is what actually influenced or impacted on me, you can say. Today, India has got a tremendous opportunity, because unlike in the yesteryears, the use of knowledge is becoming much more and more feasible, both in terms of infrastructure. See, otherwise in advanced technology areas, there is always a difficulty, because unless you establish the existing mechanism, you cannot improve on that. But when you have to go beyond that, you can make use of, for example, whatever knowledge-based systems that are coming up. But then we cannot survive on that for long. We also need to make sure that the necessary infrastructure is established. So we have a challenge in that, whether it is biotechnology or aerospace technologies, etc. In all these, we also need to make sure that the hardware systems are established in the country. One of the key things in an organization's culture is, as long as you are actually converting the technology into a usefulness in the society and you are able to see that happening and you are able to consistently make it happen, that is what has been the advantage of ISRO. And right from beginning, it had great visionary leaders like Dr. Sarabhai, Satish Dhawan, then Brahm Prakash, then Professor Rao, Rangan, and a host of them. All of them have made sure that the people working in the organization are looking at the end product, reaching out to the society. Like I was talking about, whether it is a fisherman or weather information or information to the government for monitoring and planning. In all these areas, there is a direct link from the technology to the usage, and as long as you can bring in that linkage, the people working in the organization are ready to take up many of these challenges. That link between, for example, the industry, the working where the actual things happen, to knowledge. Because unless you are able to bring in this linkage, the institutions like this, or even higher technology, higher education institutions, one of the problems that we face in the country is that you can say disconnect between actual happening and the knowledge that is being provided. So this is doing a good job, is what I can say. The contribution of India itself to using the space technology for societal benefit. Though we may be fifth or sixth country in the world, today world recognizes that India has made the best use of space technology for societal benefit.